important to keep in mind what the goal of today's modern fire training is trying to accomplish. According to NFPA 1403, is an introduction to today's modern fire environment. We want to introduce the student to what they may see out in the field as an introductory mode.
This series of tests is looking at fuel packages. How can you add or subtract from a fuel package to change the fidelity of the fire training ground or make it more real? Things like adding a sofa cushion or adding tar paper to pallets and straw to increase the amount of smoke are all thought to increase the fidelity. However, do they really? This project is going to take a look at the obscuration or opacity, how thick the smoke is, to be able to answer that very question. In addition, can you just add more fuel to make it more real? We're adding OSB, MDF, and all sorts of different configurations to determine can you actually increase the fire size to a point that's still safe but produces reality. The prop behind me is instrumented for temperature, heat flux, and smoke obscuration. The idea would be, can we use temperature to understand the size of the fire? Heat flux to understand the exposure to a potential student inside the prop. A new sensor that we've incorporated in this project is an obscuration meter. It uses a laser that is reflected back and recorded. The more the laser is reflected back to the sensor, the clearer the environment is. The less of the laser is reflected back, the less clear the environment is. Overall, we're developing an understanding of how training fuels behave inside the training prop. Understanding things like the orientation of the pallets, the number of pallets, straw versus Excelsior, will all give the fire instructor a better opportunity to not only understand the fire dynamics, but better educate their students.
So basically what this comes down to is that we are creating the building blocks of understanding basic fire science and developing that knowledge, that understanding, into our training. So we can give those students a good learning experience so they can take this basic knowledge of fire behavior, incorporate into their tactics to make informed decisions on the fire ground that will translate into better operations, more effective operations, and safer operations for those occupants and for those fellow firefighters.